Welcome to ACRIU Foundation. In this video, we are going to learn about the Python D Django concept. And these are the things that we are going to cover. What is D Django and how we can set up the D Django, how we can create an app in D Django, and what is the DTL and how we can use the operations in D Django. Then we'll move to the get and post method. Then we are going to learn what is MVT. Then we are using static files. Then we are passing that dynamic data in HTML. Then we use the for if else statements. Okay. Then we are moving to the ORM concept, that is object relational mapper. Then we'll move to the database concept. We are using the one database, that is PostgreSQL. Okay. And we are going to set up the admin. We are going to cover how to add users, super users, then sub users, and how we can create it, the register, login, logout, all these things. And what are the requirements are there to learn the D Django? That's the important thing, right? So you required, first you have to know the Python. Okay, this is a mandatory thing. Then you should know the basic knowledge of HTML, okay, CSS, okay. If you are having the concept of like framework like Bootstrap, so that's good for you, okay. But Python, HTML, this is the mandatory thing, guys, because when you are working on the front end part, so HTML is basic. You have to know about this. Okay, so let's start how we can use this D Django. Okay, so we need one editor, right, where we can write our code. So for that purpose, we are using Visual Studio. Okay. So you can download this editor. So here you can download Visual Studio Code. Okay. In mine is already installed. So if you have Windows, some other, you can use this concept. Okay. These are the links are available for 32, 65, 64. Okay. So you can download from here. So let's start. So first of all, we need one environment, right? So I'll do one thing. I'll open one folder. Go with this folder, ACRIU Foundation. So we have the file is available. Okay. So here, what I'll do, first of all, we have to check whether the Python is installed or not, right? So if the Python is not installed in your system, so you'll get some errors. So first of all, you have to install the Python. Okay, how you can install the Python? Simple things are there. Just you have to Python in the Google. Okay, you'll get this python.org is the official website. So just you have to click the download button. Okay. So automatically you can see the Python will be downloaded. Just you have to click next, next, next. So automatically it will be installed. The next thing is like you have to install the D Django also. Okay. How you can install the D Django? This you have to write in the command prompt. That's pip install. So let's first check the files are installed or not. Okay. So how to check all these things? So in the command prompt, you have to write Python, okay. Then you have to write version. Just enter it. So it is showing like in my system, Python 3.6.2 version is installed. Okay. Same thing if you want to check the D Django. So it's already installed. See here it's already installed. So if it is not installed, how you can install this? Just you have to write pip install, then you have to write D Django. Okay, so now you can see when you enter the pip install D Django, it's already installed in my system. That's why it is showing requirement already satisfied, right? So but if you are not installed, so it will install. Okay, all the files will be downloaded. You'll find the different things. Okay, so now everything is installed in our system, right? So So now what we have to do, we have to start our project, right? So for that purpose, we have to enter one command. Okay, what's the command? So for that purpose, we have to write Django admin. Then we have to write start project. Then you have to give one name. Okay, so I'll give just Acryl. Okay, you can give your own name also. Okay, so now you can see once I enter this name, you can find one Acryl folder is already here, and you can see we have one more, like manage.py file. We got all these files. How? Because the project's already started, right? So because see, these are the components. Whenever you're working on a project, so you'll be required lots of things. So automatically, Django will provide all these things. Okay, now you can see here, you got different things like in setting, like you have templates, you have VSD applications, okay, you have database, SQL Let 3, you can change the database, okay, we are going to change this, okay, you have different things are there, okay, and how we can use all these things, we're going to learn everything, okay, so not an issue for that, okay. So as of now, just ignore it, okay, we are going to learn everything, like what is URLs file, okay, everything. So first of all, we need one app, okay, so why we need app, because whenever you are working something and you want to display something, that's a particular module is your application, okay, that's your app. For example, you are creating application for like Amazon Flipkart, so mobile is in one app, okay, accessories is one app. So on that particular thing, you will be going to add some pages and add your business logics, okay. Wherever you want to display some information, so you have to create a separate app, right? So separate functionality you can add there. So let's see like how we can create an app, okay? But before that, let's see like we have this file and how we can see this information, okay? So for that purpose, we have to write, okay, first we have to be in Acryl, right? Then we have to write Python manage.py, then run server, okay? So we have to run the server because it's application, it's run on server. So by default, when you install the Django, you'll get the local server, okay? So just hit the button, and now you can see we got one IP address, right? This is the HTTP 127.0.0 and port number is something 8000. Okay, so just click, you can copy paste this, or else you can just click this link. So now you can see we got our Django project, right? So as of now, like we haven't added anything, right? So that's why it is showing that default page, and you want to learn the documentation, you can read this documentation here. Okay, you'll find everything how you can create your particular application from end to end. But now what we want is we want to change this. We want to write our own information here, right? So how we can edit all these things? So for that purpose, just we have to enter some command. What are those commands? You have to enter, first we'll go into the Acryl folder, okay? And you have to start a new app, okay? You have to create one new app. On that particular app, you have to mention your details. How we can do that? The simple things are there. Just you have to write Python, okay? You have to write manage.py. Then you have to write start app. Then you have to give the app name. So I'm just writing sample, okay? So once you enter, you can find you got one database as well as you having one folder that's called sample, right? But you can see when you start the app sample, you're having some files, but there are some files are not available, which is available in the Acryl, right? So what you have to do, you can copy paste or you can create here also, I'll just create here. That's the urls.py file. Okay. And now what you have to do, you have to link this sample file with the main file, right? Because whatever you want to display, you have to mention here. But how you can mention these things? So this is your normal information, then this is your sample app, okay, URL, and this is the main URL, right? So in this main URL, you have to mention the path of this URL, okay? And after that, you have to go to the views, okay? I'll write the views here, okay? So whatever you write in the views, it means like you are displaying that information here, okay? So here, first of all, we have to add some. I'll do one thing on this copy paste part. Okay. I'll copy paste part. And here, I'm not adding the admin part. Here, I'll add. So, this is the, I'm keeping it blank because I just want to redirect with the home page. It's like a home page. And here I have to mention views. And I'm giving one name. Okay. So I'm giving name as home. Then name equals to I'm giving also home. And one more thing I have to mention here in the views, it should be linked with the views, right? So for that purpose, I have to write a function, this home, right? And I want to return something, anything like hello world, like this is a simple thing which we write in any programming language, right? But you can see we are getting many errors, right? It's showing like your views are also not something like it is undefined, right? So we have to define somewhere, but where? So you have to import the view here. Okay, so here I'll write from main, I'll import views. Hope it's going to be solved. Yeah, it's solved, right? Next, we have to link this with views, right? And here you have to pass some request, okay? And one more thing you have to check in the main URL, this sample should be included, right? So you can include here path, okay? And write main include, and here you have to mention the your app name. So this is the sample and this URL file, okay? So whatever the URLs you are going to add, automatically it will be available here, right? And so now it is showing like path. Okay. So you have to mention here include also. Okay. Now I think you cannot get that. Okay. There is a comma. Okay. We have to mention like if you are adding number of things, you have to mention the comma also. Okay. And here view, here in the view what we are doing, we are passing the request, right? So we have to write request, and here what we are returning, we are returning a response, right? So it's a HTTP response. Okay, and still we are getting one error. Okay, this thing like HTTP response is not defined. So we have to define here. We have to write from django.http import this HTTP response. Okay, so now still we are getting this. Are we getting okay? No error, right? So now just we have to go to the CMD, this our Python. So you can see the server is not open, so I'll do one thing. I'll write Python. Again, we have to run the server. Okay, so Python manage.py run server. Once you run the server, okay, we got it, and just click on the link. Now you can see we got our own content, that's the hello world. Okay, so this is the first part we have done. Okay, we have done like how we can set up the Django, we have created the app, and now we are going to the Django template language. Means in the real time we cannot display this hello world, right? We add our HTML files, that's our content, right? So how we can implement our own templates? So for that purpose, what you have to do, the first thing is you have to create a folder where you can save your all HTML pages. So how you do? So just create a folder here. You can find this icon, new folder. So I'll give this name as a pages. You can give any name. Okay, and in this, I'll save the index.html. So mostly we write, you can write your any name. So by default, we use this index.html for home page, right? So this is the basic structure. Okay. And this information I want to display, right? But here I'll write something like I'll write welcome to active foundation of the server. NGO name, right? And now if you just refresh it, we are getting this hello world. We are not getting this content, right? Because this page is not connected with your application, right? So what you have to do, you have to mention it. But you can see in the view what you are showing. You are showing hello world. That's why it is showing in the output hello world, right? So you have to change it. How you can change? You have to mention this as a HTML file. Okay. So how you can see with, you have to use, instead of HTTP response, you have to use render. And in this you have to mention a request. Okay, and now you can everything is good, and here you have to mention something, anything. Okay, I'll just write, I'll just checking this whether the information is working or not. Okay, so just refresh it. But it is showing like template does not exist. It is showing the errors. You can see here when you're adding this render, showing like it is not exist. So you have to mention it somewhere, like it, you are using this file, but where? So for that purpose, we have something like setting.py file. So in this you have to mention it where you have this template, right? Because we are using the template, right? So you have to mention here. How you can mention? You have to write os.path dot join. Okay, then you have to mention this directory. Okay, then you have to mention it as the pages, right? So write pages, and now it should be okay. This it is showing the one error that OS is not defined, so you have to use the library. It's mostly lots of library you have to install, guys. Okay, this is the import OS. Now let's see, hope the issue is resolved. So think that we have to run the server. Okay, got it, just refresh. Okay, so still we are getting one error. The same thing like return render request hello world. Okay, so here you can see in the views we haven't mentioned our file, which is like index.html, right? So we have to mention it. What information you want to display? We want to display our index.html file, right? So we have to mention index.html. Let's save it. Yeah. Just now you can see we got our HTML page information. And if I want to if I'm changing something in the HTML, okay, here I'll write something paragraph, okay, and here write now refresh it. See, we are getting the information right. But now what we want to do means we want to pass this information through the Python code, right? So how we can do that part? So for that purpose, we use this expression. Okay. So in this, you can pass your variable type of information. Okay. Normally, like if you something like in other part, like we use a JSON format. So in we have dictionaries. Okay. So you can pass the information as a dictionary. How we can pass this information? For example, here I'll write something code. Okay. And here I'll write Python. And in this, you can see if I write something here, information. Here I'll write number name. Here you can find the code. Okay. And just refresh it. Okay. We are not getting this. Yeah, we got it because we haven't saved this, right? So now just now I have saved. So we got this. I'm learning Python. Okay, so you can. Maybe this information, this variable information is somewhere else, right? This is a different method. For example, just now simply I'm passing this Python here. Or else what you can do, you can write something like here, anything, something like course, when you're writing something like this, and here you're passing the course name. Okay, and same thing, you can pass this information here also. If I write, course one. Okay. So now you can see here, instead of Python, let's change into D Django. Okay. Now see here. Okay, see? It's changed to D Django. So there's a number of things are there. Okay. Directly you can pass the variable also, or you can pass your own information also. There are different methods with the help of those things you can. It's up to you how you can add the information. Okay. So now we are going to the operation part, like how we can do the operation. And there are some other commands also there. Okay. For example, if you want to use some theme concept and you want to implement your theme to all your pages, there are many things are there. Okay. So let's do that part. Here I'll do one thing. I'll use something like theme dot HTML. Okay. In this, what I'll do is I'll just pass this HTML file, and here I'll apply a BG color something like cyan. Okay. And here you have to mention block content. Okay. And you have to write end block. End block. Okay. State. And now we can implement this thing in index HTML. Okay, so we have command something called exp and find names, okay. And that part extension. It's not giving the suggestions. And here you have to mention the file name. So we are using the theme.html. Okay, this is our file name, and you have to close this. Okay, and after this, you have to write whatever the content you have. So using the block content. And you have to end somewhere. Okay. So here I'm using the end block. So now just refresh it. See, we are getting the cyan color, but you can see in our index.html, we haven't applied any theme, right? So what you can do, you can apply a theme somewhere in a particular file and just extend those files in all your HTML pages. So no need to write the theme again and again. And for example, if a client is saying just change the theme, so just you have to change in the one file only, right? So if you just change here, something like I'll write orange, save it and run it. Now you can see it's orange. So you don't need to spend much time on changing part, right? Because we are learning Django, right? So you have to be smart, right, with the Python. So there is a many advantages are there in Python, okay? You don't need to spend much time on the front end frameworks, right? So many things are there in the Python. You can use those things. If you want to add any something like a header part here, something like I'll write here, something like this is your header part. Okay. And now you can see, so this is your header part will be there. Okay, if I write after this, so I'll write here. This is, okay. Here we can write something like copyright 2021. Okay. So this will be remain the same for all pages, just the main content you can display as per your requirement, right? So that's good, right? But now what we want to do the operations, okay? So what type of operation? We'll do a simple calculation part, okay? So here is the index here. This is our file, and here I'll do one thing. I'll just add a form, okay? So in this form, I'll take some inputs. Okay, input type equals to something, a number. Okay, take number. Not something like I'll do the placeholder. Enter number one. Okay, I have to give the name because I want to store this value, right? Give something number one. Okay. Copy this. Because as a programmer, we have to use this button, right? Number one and number two. Okay. Here I have to change it. Number two. And this button. Right. Because we need a submit button, right? And here I'll just give the button value. I don't want submit. So I'll give the value something like submission. Okay. That's what we are doing, right? So just now refresh. We got this enter number one, number two, and do the addition part. Okay, but we want to display the result, right? And how we can display this result? You can post this into some other page, or you want to display here also. But let's do into a next page. Okay, you can take cap. Now we have to enter this. Okay, so for that purpose, here you have to mention something more. in the form, you have to mention action, okay? Because you are submitting, some action should be done, okay? And you have to mention the functionality, how which function should work, okay? And here you have to use the method, okay? We'll use both the methods, okay? First we'll go with the get, then we'll move to the post, okay? And one more thing, like you have to do the changes on where in the, first we'll create one file. So where we want to display the result, right? I'll just write something like result.html, okay? And here, just my HTML file. And here I'll write result. And here we can take this into HTML, so I'll get font. And now I want to link this file, right? So we have to map this with the URL. So after this home, you have to mention the path of this file also. Because this is not a, what you can say, not a home page, so you have to mention this result, okay? And in the views, you have got the function now, I'll give the same name result, and the name equals to result, okay? And next thing is, you have to mention in the views, right? We haven't mentioned the view. Let's see if it is right. Okay. So you have to write the function somewhere, I'll write here. Okay. Result, and here I'll write the request. Okay. And what you have to display, just return render, right? And same thing, request is passed to where it should pass to the result.html, right? That's what I'm saying. Result.html. Okay. So let's check whether the things are working or not. Okay. So just refresh it. Okay. And enter something, something 12, and addition. We are getting to the result.html page, but we are not getting the actual result. So how to print the result? So for the purpose, we have to do the operation, right? If your system doesn't know how we are calculating, right? So you're getting one error. So let's save it. Here we have to mention it, what operation you are doing. So we have, you can take any variable name, something like value one, okay? And here you have to pass a request. Which request you are using? You're using the get, right? Okay. Okay. And what's the variable name you are mentioning? We have mentioned not number one, right? And just copy this. Okay, so just end into two. And here you have to mention two. And you have to mention addition. Okay, addition of what? Value one plus value two. And where you want to display this value one, value two? Here, right? You can give any name wherever you want to display. So I'll write add, then add. Okay. This is your variable name, right? This is your variable name, add, and this add you are displaying on where in the expression. Okay. So here you can pass the expression and write add. That's it. And just now refresh and write any number 12 addition. But we are getting what? 1 2 1 2. So it's doing the concatenation. So what you have to do, you have to convert your number. By default, like it will take as a string, right? So you have to convert as an integer. How you can convert? Simple things: int open and int close. Same applicable for this part. Okay, just save it. Back to the page. Okay, refresh. 12 addition. Now you're getting the 24, right? So we have done this part. We have done the operations. We have done the kit. But how about the post? Okay. So let's do the post thing. Okay. So So just instead of using get, you have to mention post, right? Okay. And here also you have to mention, instead of get, you have to paste this as a post. Okay. Now open it, okay. Run it. We are getting one error. What's the error? Get, let's refresh. 2, 1, 2. Okay. We are getting this message. If you are passing this, what you can post, so you have to mention this CRS token. Okay. So let's mention this CRS token in your form, because when we use the get and when we use the post, okay, that's the important thing. Okay. So whenever you have data with this confidential, okay, to use the post method, because see, everything will be displaying here in when you use the get, you can find everything will be displayed here. So you cannot share the ID password to someone, right? So for that purpose, we are using the post method. Okay, whenever the information is not in the confidential, you can pass the information with the get method. Okay, but if it is a confidential, so use the post, and whenever you are using the post, mention the CRF token. Okay, so now will not get this error. Just refresh it and enter something number. Now you can see we got the result. Okay, so that's the use of get and post. Okay, and now what is like a model of view template concept? Okay, this is the like a support by the this framework called Django. So Django support model of view a template. So what is your model and what is view and what is a template? Okay. So for example, just see here, just assume this is your database. Okay. I'm not good at this point. And something like this is your template. Okay. And some user is there, they are accessing the data. Okay. Now somebody is searching here and, the data is passing somewhere, okay? This data is going to pass to this area, okay? And but what it will do now, it will go with the module, okay? So this is your model, okay? All about the database, okay? And this is your template, okay? And this is your view. Okay, so this is like how model will search. For example, any application we have created and user is something. So first it will go to the view, not go to the model directly, not go to the database. Okay, so here your business logic. That's why we call business logic. So we add all the logic in the views file. Okay, so it will not directly implement to the, not directly go to the database. It will go first the view. So view will fetch the information and view will pass the information. Okay. So this is the type of something like model, view, template. Okay. If you want to learn more, there will be a number of documentations are there, videos are, you can find that part also. Okay. So this video is compulsory, mainly we are concentrating on the coding part, right? So next, okay. So now we have this information, right? But now what we want to do, we want to pass some static files and we want to pass a dynamic data, both the things. Okay, so how we can do all these things? Okay, so for example, if I have something card model, okay, let's add any card model. Okay, for the purpose, you need a bootstrap concept. Or simply we can pass any, what we can, let's add a booster. I have this CSS JavaScript file. Okay, let's copy this and I'll paste it in our folder. Okay, here I'll pass. This is my CSS file and this is my JavaScript file. Okay, this is only we use for the bootstrap concept, right? So here what we can do, we can add the information. Okay, so let's do here. So I'll take one division, and in this division what we can pass the information. How we can pass? We can use a card model. Okay, so we take this as something like a rule. We can create a good UI, just we are passing the dummy information using normally also only. Okay, but you can, those who have known the bootstrap, they know this. Okay, so those who have don't know about the bootstrap, we have created a bootstrap videos also, so you can learn bootstrap videos. Okay. Just we have created active foundation. So we have created some basic videos on HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap. So you can go through these videos. Okay, so you'll learn some basic parts. Okay, so now what I want to implement something. Okay, so just download some images also. Okay, so let's. I'll download some files. Find many images. Let's save this image. Add with the file. Saved in this folder, right? So I don't want to, I just copy this C file and I'll paste it not here. This is our folder, right? Not this C folder. Don't have image, so I'll do one here. I'll create one IMG, and here I'll paste my photos. Okay, we have some three photos. Okay, so we can write three photos here. So just quickly I'll write the thing. Image, the star C, and here go to the image, I'll write C++. Okay, and here add some other parts. You can take this into a card model also. How we can take this class equals to card. Part. Okay. Class equals to header. Okay. And after this, post this into a header part. Okay, and I'll use one more. Body. This part, I'll add just here I need one more class equals to here I'll write button something. One color class equals to but let's see how it's refresh. But we are not getting this image, right? So we'll see like what's the issue and why we are not getting the image. Okay, so let's add This is our column, right? So it's starting and ending here. So I'll copy this one. Okay, so I'll just change the name. Java. We got these three things again, I mean one by one. How we can resolve this issue. Okay, so now we have files, okay, we have images, okay. But the thing is, like, it is not connected, right? So for that purpose, what we have to do, we have to connect this, right? And how we can connect this, okay? So for that purpose, in the template, what you have to mention, you have to mention a static information, okay? Because we are pasting the static information, right? So that's why we have to mention there. But how we can mention all this? Okay, so we have to follow some what you can say simple steps. Okay, so with the help of those steps, we can pass our data. Okay, but what are the steps? Okay, so we have updated the information, okay, and now we have to import. Okay, where we can import, we have to mention in static. Okay, so in static means we have a setting.file. So in this, we have static somewhere. This is the static. Okay, so here you have to mention the directory of your static files. Okay, so but there is no static folder we have created, right? So what you have to do, you have to create a separate folder for static. Okay, and you have to copy paste this information. Okay, copy this information and pass this information into a new folder that is static. Okay, you can give it some other name also, but let give this like a static. Okay, so you have all this information in the static folder. Now you have to tell that this information is in the static. Okay, so for that purpose, just you have to write here the directory first. Okay, so what directory you have to mention? Static URL is already there. So static directory, static file. Okay, and directory. Okay, then you have to mention the directory. So you have to mention the path actually. So os dot path, and you have to mention join, and you have to mention this directory. And what's the directory name? The directory name is static. Okay, and thus after this you have to mention the root. So build the root now. So what we have to do, we have saved this in the static folder, okay? But if you just write like this and you want to implement, it will not work. So what you have to do, you have to make this static files as a assets, okay? So in on the particular assets, you will be having your all the assets like your CSS, your JavaScript, and your images. So how we can do, we have to write a root, okay? So we have to write static, and then you have to mention as a root. And in this, you have to mention the path, os.path, and you have to mention join. And here, same thing, base directory. And after this, you have to mention asset, okay? But we haven't saved any assets, right? So what you have to do, you have to collect the assets. How you can collect the assets? you have to mention one command in the CMD prompt. Okay, so we don't have any asset, right? That's why we have to collect the all the static information. So just write cd attribute. Okay, and this you have to mention Python manage dot py, and you have to mention the collect static command. So the command name itself as a collect static. Okay, so see here we don't have asset folder. Once I enter this, taking time, maybe loading the files. You can see here we got the information 158 static files copied to assets. So now you can see, just check where. Okay, we got the folder called assets. We haven't created, but see, we got the asset folder. Now what we have to do, we have to load the static files. Now you can see we are not getting the information exactly. See, if I just run it, you are not getting the files till now. So what you have to do, you have to load the files. How you can load? In the index file, you have to mention the top side. So here you have to mention the load static. Okay, load static. Okay, and once you load this, still you have to write something more, guys. Okay, so what are the things? So we have used the CSS and Bootstrap files, right? So you have to link those files. So we have to write link. The CSS file. Okay, I'll use this mini.css style. Right. And you have to write the script also. We have to mention src equals to this folder. We have this Java jQuery file. One more switch. Here we have to mention the proper.js folder file. Proper.js file. Let's add the JavaScript file now. Let's go with the Bootstrap mini.js. We got all the things. Now you can see this. Okay, we are getting still error. Okay, what's the error? This extend theme schema, right? So we don't want this. Okay, let's keep sending out this thing. Okay, so because we are applying our own thing. Okay. Now refresh. Okay. We got this, but still we are not getting the files because still you have to do lots of things. Okay, so what you have to do? You have to write here this symbol. Okay. And here where? You have to mention static. So this static. Okay. And here you have to use this quotes. Then after that you have to mention this close. Okay. Okay. And same thing you have to apply everywhere. You are adding this everywhere. Okay. Do the control C, control V, because we have a famous quotation. Behind a successful developer, there is a Control C and Control V button. Okay, so and see, let's run it. Now I can see we got the buttons change, right? But still we are getting one issue that images are not fine. Okay, so we have to mention the image also, right? Okay. In the last. And here in the starting part, copy and paste it. Okay, now run it. We got the first image, right? So just after this, just mention the class equals to image fluid, so you get the responsive image. Okay, and implement the same thing for all. Just use copy and paste it. Here also copy paste and the last part also. Copy paste it. Same thing for here. Now refresh it. These images are very big, that's why we are getting like this. So, okay. This is the first row, right? Columns. That's pretty good. Or maybe I'm missing. One, two, three, right? That's right. Okay. So we got these three things. Okay, let's take So now you can see we got these three things, okay, but what I want to, now everything I am creating manually, right? But what I want to paste this data dynamically. Okay, this is the information which we have added static, right? So this is the part which we have done, right? Static files part. But what I want to pass this information dynamically. Okay, so dynamically information should pass. So how we can do that part? So for that purpose, what we have to do, we have to create a model with the help of that model. What we can do, we can pass our information dynamically, right? So that's our goal, right? Because that data might be coming from somewhere, right? And now how we can do that part? Okay. For example, what we can do, we can create a model, because that's a structure, right? The data may be saving somewhere here and we are fetching the data from the views, right? So we need a model, right? So do Django provide model? Yes, it's provide model. So where you can check the model file? Okay, so if you just create a model, so just you can see here in the sample we have a model file. This is your model file. So here what you can do, you can create your model. Okay, so simple things are there. Just you have to mention a class. Okay, because in a class you can create number of objects, right? So just I'm writing code, and here I'm just mentioning some information, something like name of the course, and it's in the string format, right? I want to update the price of the course, and it's in maybe an integer format. Something like I want to pass some more thing, something like image. Yes, I want to pass image, so I'll write string, because we pass the file name, right? And if I want to pass something like any whether the for this offer is there or not, just let's do this part later. Okay, so first you implement this part. Okay, now what we want to add this information in our views file. Okay, this is your view file. Here you have to implement, right? So how you can implement this thing? So first of all, what you have to do, you have to create an object. Okay, but how you can create the object? So in this we have index, right? In this index.html, I'll do one thing, just remove this part. Okay, and here I have to pass my information. And here, how I can pass the information? If I create an object of this class, so how I can create object? I'll write course one. I'll remove this because it will be a mess up, right? If I write the same thing twice. Okay, so course one here I'm writing, and the object is my course, right? So there will be a number of courses will be there, right? So what is showing the error? The course is not defined. Yes, it is not defined because we haven't mentioned what is the course, right? So what you have to do, you have to import the model which you have mentioned. So you have to map the model with a view. So for that purpose, you have to write from this main here model import. What you have to import? You have to import the course, right? You have to import this. Now you are not getting the error. So we have three courses are there. In future, if you want to add more courses, you can add more courses. So let it be course one, course two, and course three. Okay. Now what we have to do? We have to add the details of this course. For example, how? Like you can write something like this: course one dot name. Okay. And what's the name of this course? I'll write Python. Okay. And course one dot image. Right. Now we can mention this image. So we have to the element, right? In the assets, we have image and the file name is Python, like python.png, right? So we mentioned python.png, okay? And here we have something more. How many things we have given the model? Name, price, image, three things like that, right? Name, okay, you have to pass. So here I'll write something like 200 something. Okay. And we don't have mentioned the price here, right? So I'll add price somewhere. Here I'll write. Price in dollar something. Okay, so we have done this course one. So same thing I'll do for course two and course three. Okay, so just I have to change the name two and this two. Okay, sorry, I have to mention three, right? So this will be the course three, a three, and here also three. Okay, so I'll just change the something three and this. Okay, and so what I can do, I can create a list of all these objects, right? From something like here, like I create courses equals to, in this list, I'll mention course one. Okay, I'll mention course two, course three. If someone has added automatically, so it will display that part. Okay, so here we will do courses. And now everything is saved here, okay, as a courses. But how we can implement these things with our HTML file, right? That's the question, because now just we have added here, okay, but when you check, when you just refresh here, we are not getting the prices, all these things, right? Also the server is stopped, so let's run the server. also okay. So we are getting, again we are getting in the URLs we are still having some error, right? So now how we can display this information with the index.html, because we have created all these objects, okay? And now what we want to do, we want to implement these things with the object, right? But how we can implement all these things? So what you have to do, we have a concept called for loop, right? So you have the data, right? But how you can display all these things? So for that purpose, simple things, what you have to do, you have to write in the, okay, so this is starting from here. So here simply I can pass the a loop, okay, because everything is repeating, right? So for that purpose, I don't require all these stuffs. So I'll delete this two part. Starting here. Explosion. Here. Now you have to see here, this is just a one loop, okay? And here you can pass your information dynamically, okay? Maybe in the information will be extent, right? So for that purpose, simply we are using the for loop. For, okay? And here you can mention anything, something like extreme courses, you can give any name here in the place of X, okay? So courses is here, right? What we have mentioned, course, okay? So you have to mention course, and you have to close this for loop somewhere, where? Here, right? So make sure whenever you are starting the loop, you have to end the loop in the same, okay? In the same direction, right? End loop. Now here you have to pass the information. So instead of this C++, I can give the name, right? So what I'll do, I'll just pass the name I'll give the X dot here name I'm passing, right? So and here the price. So for this I'll just pass the price, that is x dot price, right? Because whatever the price are there here, automatically it will pass, right? And here I'll mention footer, I've added the footer, right? But in the images, it is showing like image C++ png, okay? We don't need to mention C++. So what we have to mention? So we have to remove this, okay? We don't want this part, okay? How we can implement this? So we have to mention this part. Okay. So in the first part, you have to mention the base URL, because you are accessing the information through a URL, right? And now you have to mention the path. Okay. So this is the image. IMG we have created. Okay, so that's it, and let's see it's working or not. Okay, but we have to write the base URL, we have to add here also, because we have mentioned the base URL. So how it will check, I'll write here static, okay, img, okay, is the my base URL, okay. So we have to close this. We are still getting, so maybe server is closed. Active, because why we are adding the CV active? Because everything is in the active folder, right? PWCRUE. Okay, we got it in the folder. Now we have to mention Python manage.py. Get this. Okay, we are getting some error. That's the error in where in the views.py file. What's the error? It is showing that from dot model. Okay, so the file name is model, not model. I'm sorry, models. So we have to make sure the spellings, okay, and again. And okay, we got zero issues and just open the link. Okay, we got one error. Okay, what's the error now? Okay, we have mentioned the end loop, but we have used the for loop. Okay, so just a mistake. So we have to write end for, right? So make sure the small thing. Okay. Now you can see here we got the thing, but we are not getting the images till now. Okay, so what's the issue? By mistake the typing error. Okay, you have typed X. So we got the same images. Okay, but we want the different images, right? So we got the same images. So let's check what's the issue, like how we're getting the same images. Okay. Get the different image, right? Because we are going through the loop, right? And the prices, yeah, prices are different. Okay, the mean. What's the issue? The thing 1, 2, 3 course 1, course 2, course 3. Okay, because we have mentioned everywhere in the Python PNG, that's why we are getting the Python PNG, right? So we have to change it. We have to give the name C++, okay, Java. Okay, so now you can see according to that it will take the name also. Okay, so names also we have to change here. Right, because we have given the same name. Just I have copy pasted the things, but I haven't changed. That's why we are getting like this. So make sure you are doing this thing. Okay, so you have to know. That's okay. Now we solve all the errors. We got the information, right? Python, C++, Java, everything is coming. Okay, and now the thing is, like, what if I want to something like make a special offer for these courses, okay, and you want to display the things like this, if these things are in the offer, these are not in the offer, okay, and how we can do that part. Okay, that's interesting, right? So you can just think like how we can do that part, because simply if you are thing like passing anything information between, like, this should be in the offer and then this should be not. So what would be the option that, like, how you can display the thing? Okay, so that's like yes and no. So we have a boolean, right? So with the help of boolean means it might be true or false, that's it, right? So how we can mention this? You can mention offer, okay, and this in a data type is boolean. And you have to mention in the views also, okay? And how you can mention, I'll add one more thing. That's the course one, it's an offer or not, okay? So yes, it's an offer, so I'm writing true. And what about other courses? I'll make it as a false, okay? So others are not an offer, so I'll write here false, okay? Same thing, that is true here, copy, I will paste it here, how we can pass this information in index.html. So I'll pass it somewhere in the button only. Okay, so I'll do one thing, button, and just try it. Something, I'll write a message, something like special offer. Let the as a offer, as a learn. Okay, and create heading something. Something just create a special offer. Okay, so just refresh it. But we are getting this special offer for everyone, right? I'll just make this as a note highlighted. I can apply a class where you can implement something easy. So, but it is getting for everyone. I want this for special purpose only. Okay, so how we can display? So what I can do, I can write the thing is the condition. Like if this, if I want to for this purpose or that purpose, okay, but this is the like if else condition, right? And how we can do that part, okay? So before that, I'll write here, I'll add the condition, my if this, something like that. Okay, why we are reading the x? Because we are using the x in the sequence for the for loop, right? And here I write offer. Okay, if it's an offer, so it should display, otherwise no need to display, right? Let's close the end loop. And not loop, it's end if, and it, right? So if you have multiple conditions, you can write else, if else, and you can write equals to, not equals. Just we have true and false, that's why I'm writing like that. Okay. So now you can see we got only one for special offer. Why? Because we have mentioned true here. Okay. If I make true for C++, see here, you will get the magic. So you can see here we got the special offer for this part also. Okay, so now you can see we have successfully implement the for loop condition, if else condition. We are passing the data dynamically. Okay, but the thing is like how we can fetch the data from the database and how we can pass data. So that comes as a ORM concept. Okay, so this object relation mapper is connected with your model, and you can connect with your database. So what you have to do, just you have to create a model in your Python, and automatically it will create tables in your database. That's like if I say like something like, if you're creating the things in Python, automatically the things are creating in database. So that's really the magic, right? So, but we can do that part. How means like simple things are there, okay? Just we have to install the database. So in my system, a database is already installed. So how I'll show you like how you can install those things. Okay. So here, what you have to do, just you have to two things you have to install. Okay. So just note down if you have. I'll just make this into in the description. Also, I'll add this link. Okay. So first of all, what you have to do, you have to install this PostgreSQL. Okay, this not this one. Yeah. So you have to download this part. Okay, if you click this download, you'll find. So you have to download the Windows version. Okay, and one more thing, you have to install one more thing. That's the database, right? So where you can, how you can check the total thing, the graphical user interface, the GUI, right? So you have to install this PGAdmin. This is PostgreSQL. Okay, so if you just click it, you'll find download. Yeah, you'll find download. Yeah, you have Windows, you can Windows, you have something like Mac, so you can download those things. Okay, so as per your system compatibility, download the same thing. Okay, now next thing is like after installing, you have to give any password. So give any password which will be suitable for you. Okay. But and just in my system is already installed. You can see here. Taking some time. Okay, so it's started now. So it will take time. It depend upon the system. If your system is fast, so it will install very quickly and open also very quickly. What we do, it's taking longer than Okay, meanwhile, what we can do, just we can go to the setting.py file. Where's the setting? This is our setting file. And here you have to change the database, right? So by default, we got the database. Okay, it's open now. Okay. So, okay, you have to mention it. So whatever the password you have given, you have to mention the password and just click on the OK. And here, if you just click, it will refresh. Now you can see it is refreshing the PostgreSQL database and issuing the two databases. So if you install, you will get only one database. Okay. In my system, two databases are there. Okay, you can create one more database. How you can create the database? Just you have to right click and you have to click on the create and database. You can give any name. Let's give, I'll give something like org organization. Okay, just save it. Once you save it, take some time. Yeah, now you can see you got one more database, but there's no table. You can see here, because if you go to the table, then you don't have the table, right? Nothing is there, no properties are available. Okay, so what we want to create a table, but how you want to create the table? We want to create the table using the Python. So how you can do that part? So just go to the setting.py and here you have to mention the static file. Okay, this is the database, right? So remove the SQLite 3 and add the database. Okay, you have to mention just as a PostgreSQL, right? So just like PostgreSQL. Okay, and after that you have to mention the name. Okay, what's the name we have to mention? Okay, just remove it. So the name will be, you have to write the database name. Okay, what's the database name? So we have given org, right? So you have to write org. And next you have to use the user. It should be in capital. And here you have to mention PostgreSQL. Okay. So by default, we haven't changed the user, so this is the same. And next, you have to mention the password. Yes, you have to use the password. So I have just given 1234. So, writing 1234. And here, you have to mention the host. Okay. So we are just using the local host. So, I'm just adding the local host. Maybe in the real time, the data might be somewhere focusing some other server. So, you have to mention that server. Okay. So, as of now, just local host. Okay. Just save it. Okay. We have done this part. Okay, now the next thing. So what we have to do means this Python, this project, okay, this total Django project, it should be connected where with this database, right? So how you can correct this database with the Python? Okay. For example, I am using a wireless mouse. But how can use? You need one adapter, right? You need a connector. So with the help of that connector, you can use, right? So we have a connector, the connector library. We have a library, okay? We have to install that library. How you can use that library? I'll show you. I'll just give you the name. So, this is the library. If you search in the Google, you'll get the library this name. So you can see that you can read this documentation later also. You can see the PsyCorp is the most popular PostgreSQL database adapter for the Python programming language. Okay, so we are using this adapter to add and update the information with the database, right? So for that purpose, just terminal, go to the here you have to install the library. Okay, how you can install this library? So just simply you have to write pip install. I think it's already installed in my system. Okay, if it is not installed, it is installed. So you can copy paste from the Google also. Okay, so it is showing me that requirement already satisfied, means this library is already installed in my system. I can use this library. Okay, now everything is done in your system. Maybe you will get the error. Maybe you will get this library. Okay, so after completing this, if you get any error, so install Pillow library also. Okay, so that library is used to capture the data. Okay, approve the data. Okay, so this is the library name. And okay, you can note down. It's better to note down. This is the Pillow library for Python. Okay, so you can install this library. Just you have to write pip install Pillow. Okay, that's it. Okay, maybe like you will get the suggestion in your Visual Studio also. Okay, now the thing is like how we can implement those things. Okay, so for that purpose, what we have to do, you have to add the parameter in your model. So what's the model? You have right here model models dot model. Okay, so here you have to save it, and after that what you have to do, you have to and add this information. Okay, what type of information you want to add? So here you cannot write string all these things, right? You have to add some fields, because if you are writing the SQL, you need fields, right? So this should be equal. Okay, so you can learn all about this in the Django also. Okay, we just click this fields. Admin template testing. Forms, sales. Yeah, you can see built-in fields. You can see here, we have different fields are there for character field, what type of information, class, character field. Okay, you have to pass the things. Okay, required maximum length. So you'll find all the things, okay? Whichever field you want to enter. Okay, so here for the name, which field we have to enter. Okay, so we are giving some name, so we have to write models. Okay, then you have to write text field, and you have to mention what would be the maximum length you are writing. Okay, maximum length equals, I'll write something like 50 characters, you know. Okay. And after that, you can pass some optional database, okay, union, okay, that's the things are optional, okay. And the price may be in an integer format, right? So you can write like certain models, and integer, right? Integer field, and you have to write this. Okay, and then we have models image, we have in the we have applied import some folder, right? So we have to write image field, okay, and we have to pass it. It should be upload somewhere. Okay, so we have to write upload to where, which folder? You can give any name. I'll give just img. Okay, so it will be upload to the img folder, and we are giving some more thing like offer. I'm giving models dot boolean field, right? Okay, so everything is done. We have given the name, we have given the price, okay, we have given the image also. But if you want to add more, you can add more field also. And now what we have to do, you have to migrate this information to the database, because this information is saved here only, right? And you have to update this information. And how you can update this information? Okay, so for that purpose, what you have to do, you have to write one command. And before that, what you have to do, you have to mention in your app this particular app. What is an app name? You have an app name, right? This app name should be saved in the where, in the setting.py. So this is the setting.py, and you will find app. Okay, this is the app, but you can see this app name is not there in your setting.py. This is your app name, right? So you have to mention this app name. So you have to write app, okay, name. App name is, app name is sample, right? Sample, okay. Then you have to write app, okay. Then you have to write sample config, okay. The app name config. Okay. Now what you have to do is write the run the command. So let's save it. I think everything is here. Okay, now you have to write Python manage.py. Do the migration. Okay. Make migration. Okay, so it's showing, did you make migration? Make migrations. Maybe it's make migrations. Okay, we got one error. What is the error? Okay, so the translate host name to address unknown server. Okay, we have at the last host, so this is actually the local host. So make sure I will do the always spelling mistakes. Okay, so we have to the local host and just do that once again. Now you can see we got the successfully we got this create model courses, right? We got it, and you can see we got one more file, that's 0001 initial. So just check in the migration, we got this file. Okay, so now we have to use this file and we have to migrate with the SQL command. Okay, so now just what we have to do, we have to mention this Python manage.py. We have to write SQL, okay, migrate. So we don't need to write the SQL query for in the database. Okay, migrate. Okay, and the app name. What is the app name? We are using the sample, and the file name. The file name is 00001. Right. So just enter migrate. Okay, enter it. See, now it is showing like created model course. We got this create table. The table name is sample course, we got all the things, IDs, name. Okay, just if you want to check, you can check it. Just refresh, refresh here. And now see, we got the arrow mark. Earlier, we are not getting the arrow mark. And just double click it. And here you can here also. Refresh, okay. Refresh, and we are still not getting. Okay, now what you have to do? Okay, I think we have to mention one more time. Okay, let's mention Python dot finally migrate. Okay, now we have got it, right? So just refresh now. Hope we will get this. Yes, we got it, right? We got all the information, and you can see here we have sample courses. Now just click on the all rows. Now you can see we got, yes, we got name, we got price, we got image, and we got offer. Okay, so we have created successfully table without using the SQL query. Okay, and it's saved in Python project and as well in the database, and everything is connected. Let's do the updation process. Okay, now what we want to do, I want to update this admin panel. How we can do the admin panel? Okay, so see here, like if I write something like this. Okay, if I write something like this, / admin. So server is off. Let's on the server. Okay, so / admin. We got the admin panel, but we don't have any user ID and password, right? So what we have to do, the next thing, so we have to create a super user, right? So we can add the information, and we can add sub users also, right? But how to do that part? So we'll see now. Okay, so we have done the migration part, right? We have done everything. And now what we have to do, we have to add the admin panel. Okay, so simple steps are there for admin panel also. So first of all, what you have to do, go to the CMD forms. Okay, I'll just create one more. Okay, and here you have to mention Python. Okay. Dot py, and you have to write create super user. Create super user. Okay. So it is showing like username, leave blank to use Ilias, because in this my system name is, it is showing. I want different name. What name you want? I want admin. Okay. Okay, so email address, I'll give something like admin@acru something. Okay, I'll make that a short dot org something. Okay. Password, I'll give simple 1234 1234. It's showing me that the password we have given very short, it's common, and everything in the numeric. So this we are giving the practice purpose. So go ahead. Yes, I'll go with this. So now just check in the database. Let's check in the database. This is our user. All rows. Now you can see we got the admin, right? We got the admin, and your password is in the encrypted format. Okay. One can read this password. Now let's check, can we log in or not? Let's refresh. Admin, the password is 1234, login. But see, we are got the admin page, but the thing is like, how we can add the details? We need one page here. So if you add any information on the page, it should be added here, right? So go to the command prompt, and what we have to do here, we have to create a page. So how we can create a page? So we have admin, yeah, this is our admin file, and here you have to connect the model. Okay, how we can connect? We have to write from dot model, and we have to write import class name. For the class name, we have given the course, right? Yeah, we have given the course, and we have to mention the we have to register the admin here, right? So we have to write admin dot write dot register. Okay, and after that you have to mention the model name. What's the model name we have given? The model name is also right, so which means then we are not getting any error. Okay, just refresh once again. Now you can see we got the courses. That's magic, right? Where we have created the model and how we are getting the database. And you can see here we can add the course also, right? And I'll do one thing. I'll just delete the courses which I have added. We have to go into the views, right? And let's delete everything, because now what I want to fetch the information from where? From the database, right? I want to update the information from the database. So courses is already there, right? Just I have to mention the courses. Courses. So this is my object. Okay. Object should be. Now what I have to do? I have to. I can add the information, right? So I'll do one thing right now. I'll just add some different information. Maybe something you are given a user authority to someone, and he is using in his own system, and that information are saved in desktop somewhere. Okay, so let's do that part. Okay, so I'll do one thing. Now I'll just add some information. Let's download some. To save this image, I want to save. Maybe it's maybe in a desktop. Just assume it's in a desktop. We have here also C, right? So I'll write and save with the C. Okay. So now if you just run the server, this was server running, right? So see here, we don't have any information. Okay, because course object is not iterable. Okay. So here we have that course. And what I can okay, because nothing is information is saved, that's why it is showing like that. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to update the information, right? And here I'm updating the information to the admin panel. Okay, so what I'll do here, okay, add the course name. Okay, the name I'm giving C. Okay, I'll just go with the C++. Okay, and I'll do one thing, I'll just divide this into this course are there, so I'll do it 6, so it will come as a two part. Okay, so I first I'll go with the C++. Okay, anything, the price I'm giving something like $500. Choose the file from where I want to upload, from the desktop image. So this is a C++. Open it. If you want to make this offer, I don't want to make the offer. Just save it. Now you can see we got one object, right? So let's do quickly for the other, like Java. something $800. Choose file, Java, open. I don't want to make this as an offer. It's too Python. And I'll give him something that's $200. Choose the file, Python, and I want to make this as an offer. So save it. I'll create one more for C. I'll create something like $150. That's my C language. I'll make this as an offer and save it. So now we have these four objects. And now what I want to do, I want to update this information here, right? But we are not getting this. Okay, so we have to solve this. So now you can see we have this information and this media, you have to update the media information. Okay, how you can update this media? So go to the setting files. Okay, and here you have mentioned earlier as a static, right? Because you are updating the static information. Now we are updating the media information. It may be like user is somewhere like you can see the social media. We are updating the information from our own media, right? Our own folder. So you have to update the information. You have to mention the media. So how we can add the media here? So first of all, you have to import it. So first of all, okay, yeah, here I'll write media, in capital, okay, media, then you have to mention URL, okay, and same thing you have write static, right, so same thing you have to mention media, this should be in like this, okay, that's how we have written the static. Then after that, you have to mention the root file, okay. So you have to mention media root, okay. So from where it is taking, right? So you have to write os.path.join and you have to mention the base directory and here you have to mention it from where it, from how we are doing. Okay, so it's, you have to mention media, small. Okay, that's it. Save. Once you save, okay, done. And now what we have to do, we have done this part. Now the second part, we have to go to the main URL. Okay, so your main URL, okay, not this one. This is your main URL, okay. And in this also, you have to update your information, okay. How you have to update it, you have to write the join, like something like plus, you can add or you can take a new variable and you can store that part also, okay. Here I'm just using the plus symbol and here I'm using static, okay. And here I'm mentioning settings dot media URL, okay. And the document I have to mention, document root, I have to mention settings dot media root. Okay, that's it. Okay, simple things are there, just we have added the main URL. Now what we have to do, we have to import this settings, right? Okay, and this library. Okay, how we can import this? Okay, from the channel, right? From the channel, okay. For configuration, we have a configuration file and you have to import the settings. Okay, then you have to mention the static also, right? Because we are getting the error from the static. So from the channel, we have to mention configuration file, the URL file, the static and import the static. Okay, that's it. Now you do not get any error. The next thing that what we have to do, you have to once you have added the information in the views, Okay, here how you can, yeah, how you have tried means you have to create an object, right? You are using the with the forces, okay, and this should be saved with the class name. So the class name is force, okay, and you are creating all the objects, right? So you have to write objects dot all, means whatever the objects you are creating in here, it should be linked to here, okay. Then what you have to do, you have to link this information with the index.html. okay, so now you can see, if you just update this, now you can see we are getting the C++, Java, Python, C, everything. We are getting the two for special offer, but we are not getting the images, right? So what you have to do, you have to change the image also, okay. So earlier we have given the base URL because we are taking the static information, right? So now what you have to do, you don't need to write the base URL. The thing is, like, you have to mention x.image, right? So before this image URL, okay, you have to do a variable name, right? So this is the x image, and now you're taking from the URL, right? So you have to mention the URL, that's it, okay? So now refresh it. We are getting some error. Oops, right. X dot image and save it. Let's run this one. For loop image and UI. Just check whether the information is saved or not. Okay, we are not getting the files, right? So we'll do one thing, we'll just write the files once again. Okay. So it's which one? The C, right? So for this C, we have write C and save it. Okay, for object C. Use file Python, save it. Object 2, Java, again, save it. Object 1, now run the file. Now we got it, right? So the images are not uploaded, that's why it is showing the error. Okay, now we got everything, right? We have done this part, okay? We have done the add and fetch the data from the database, right? But now what we have to do, we have to pass the messages and the user login and logout. How we can do that part, okay? So the simple things are there, just what you have to do. We have to, we are getting something, course object one, course object two. I'm learning this part, okay, because we have deleted this part, right? That's why we are getting this, okay? So what we have to do, we have to create an account, okay? That account should be created. Here, I'll do one thing, I'll just create one more. CD attribute, okay? And just we have to quickly, we have to do, we have to add the accounts. Okay. So what we can do means we can create a separate app, okay, for accounts, and where we can update all the information, okay? How we can do that part? Simply something like Python, okay, dot manage dot py, and here we can mention that app account. Okay, and once you enter this. We got account. Yeah, we got the account file. Okay, so just do the quickly things. Okay, just we have write the new file. That's the URL file. So whenever you create any account app, sorry, you have to mention this. So URL.py. Okay, so same thing. What you have to do, you have to copy paste the same thing how we have done here. Okay. Example. So same thing you have to mention in these. These are the simple things, right? We have to copy paste the same thing, the accounts, okay, but not the exact this URL, right? You have to add the URL file, okay, and just we have to mention only one thing. We don't need the home, right? So we need register, okay? So whenever I want to use the register, login and logout, so these three things I want. So, okay, so I'll write first register.html, okay, the name also is register, okay, and here results also I give register, okay, and same thing, I'll create multiple things, okay, I need a register, I need a login, logout, all these things, so I'll just copy and again I'll paste it, okay. So this is for login and this is for logout. We have to repeat here. Logout here. Login. Login. Okay, and we have to create three pages here. So the pages, just the pages, the pages, right? So here we have to create one page is for register, register.html. Okay, and one page you have to create login.html, and one page you have to create logout. Okay, these are things that you have to create. And now what you have to do, you have to create what you can say the views, okay? So you have URLs, right? And you have to update this information in the views also, okay? Because it is not important in the views, okay? So you have to create three functions. One is the function for register, okay? Just call the request, okay? And the same thing what you have to do, you have to something render a request, okay? Render request to where to register dot. So same thing you have to do with all. For this is for login and this is for logout. Okay, so this would be login and this would be for what you have to do. You have to add the functionality. What functionality you want to add, right? So for that purpose, let's just save it and go. Okay, working. Because these things are okay, request these functions are not defined. Go to the URL login. Register login views dot register login. You see this part. Okay. So we have this login, logout, and these pages, right? So now what we can implement for register, we have to create an account, right? So in the register, okay, so what we have done till now, okay, we have created login, logout, and register html.page, right? So now we have to update the information, okay? So when you register something, we need one form, right? So let's create a form here. We need a form so where user can register his details, right? So for the purpose, simple, what we do, we write a form. So form open and form close. And in this form, what we have to do, we have to take an action. So where it should be registered. Is clicking the submit button, should go to the register, and it should be confidential details. Okay, so it should be in a post method, and now we have to use the CSRF token. Okay. Here we have to mention the details, but which information we have to take? If we just go to the user, okay, and go to the columns. You can see we have ID, password, a username, first name, last name, and email. So this information we can take. Okay. So here you can input, okay, and type equals to first. Let's take the first name. The text format, right? So we have write text here, and here name we have to mention. Make sure the name you are giving, it should be same with this name, these names. Okay, so first I'll go with the first name. Okay, and the placeholder I'll add something that enter your first name. my first input. I can copy paste details. This is the last name. Here I will add it. Last name, and here also last. Okay. And next would be the username. So we have to mention it. Username. Here also. Then we need email address. Email is here, so here we also change it to email. Here I write email, and next we need password. Okay, so these are things, right? We got first name, last name, username, email, then we need password. So for password, type equals to password. And in the name also you have to mention password. So I'll do one thing. I'll take two passwords. Here, one for the normal password and one for the verification purpose. Okay. I'll just copy paste the same thing. So here I'll take as a password two. Here I'll write to re-enter your password. And then we need a submit. Here type equals to submit. And here in this I'll write value equals to register. And here again that's it. That's it, right? So let's see like it's working or not. Before that you have to make some changes, right? In the accounts view file, this account, this is URL and view. Make sure all the functions are we adding. This is for register purpose, okay? And this is for register, right? So we have to mention it. Login. We have to mention this logout. Okay, so three functionalities are added. And in the URL, we see we have views, login, logout, right? And in the main URL, we have to mention, see here, the app name sample is added. Same thing, you have to mention the account also. Okay, so how you want to mention like accounts backslash. So accounts after the slash, you can give register. Little bit different names would be there, right? Logout, login, okay. Then we have to write include, and here you have to mention your accounts URL. Okay. And in the index.html, same thing, what you have to do, you have to create some hyperlinks. Okay, so where we can do do in the starting part, say the center tag. So you can manage it, center part. Take a fusion. Here I'll take hyperlink reference. Okay. What would be like index.html? Here I'll write the home. Then just refresh it. We are just in the server. Okay, we got one invalid index. Python admin line number 24 URLs.py. So let's check what's the error. we have to mention the from. Now we got it. Just follow the link. Now you can see we have a home page, so I'll do one thing, I'll create all the pages now. Okay. I'll just copy paste. Here after the index, I'll go with the register. This is the product of our website account. Plus we have quite a register. Same thing, login page. Copy this thing, paste it here. Okay, we need a login page. This is a refresh. Now, I think so one by one we have put in. Okay, so this is. Register and this is a function here. Here. The things are there, the home base is the one to make this a center. So now we have these three things. Okay, now we want to implement this. For example, if I click on the register, yeah, we have got this register page, right? The first name, last name, username, password. Okay, but we have to add some functionality. So these inputs can be saved, right? So now go to the views file. Okay, the accounts. This is our accounts and this is the view. And here we have to mention the functionality in the register, right? So for register, what I'm doing, I am writing if, okay? I'm adding the condition if my request is coming through which method? So the method equals to post, okay? Post, okay? So what should do? So for this request, we have to capture the information. What are the information are there? We have first name, okay, and the request is right, and what variable name is the first name. Right. So same thing, I have to capture this, copy and paste the information. So first name, last name, username, password 1 and password 2. Right? So just rename the thing. So this will be a last name and this will be your username and this is your password 1. Okay, and this will be your password 2. And here also you have to change the thing. Last name, the name, and password 1. The email, right? Written all the fields 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now what you have to do, you have to save somewhere, right? This functionality. Okay, you have written everything. Now what you have to do, this email is there, okay? And now what we have to do, we have to write like the condition. Okay, what would the condition is this if password 1 equals to password 2. Okay, then what should do? So we have to write one more condition. In the condition, we are writing this user dot object. Okay, the objects which we have written. Okay, this object I want to filter it. Okay. Filter which way, like it should be, we have to add some condition, like the username should be same. If you cannot write the username, okay, it means you cannot repeat the username. You have to be write the different name whenever you are registering. Okay, so if I'm writing this function, is this exist? Okay, if this exists, what should be? So here I'm passing them one message. Okay. I'll show you how to pass the message, but here we are adding the message dot info. That's what the information you want to pass. I want to pass the user name. Username taken something. And same message, I want to pass if someone is like entering the email ID also. Okay. Here I have typed. Email. Okay, and here I write email. Message. After that, what you can add? So if everything is fine, so what we can do, we can pass one more, okay? It should be written a message. It should be, okay, no, it should be redirect. Fine, once the user is created, it should be redirect. And it should be redirect to where it is a register, okay? Okay. Or else if you want to add some more conditions, you can add else if. What would be the next condition? Okay, here we have further issues. Okay. And it should be like, okay, copy this. I have to pass this message here also. Okay. And here, else, okay. And finally, what I can do is the else part and I can display the message something. So, equals to user dot optics. Dot create, okay, looks like create user and you have to add all the information which information you want to create, like for example you have to write a username also. This username should be username, okay, and you have to pass all the parameters. So the email should be the email, the first name equals to first name, the last name equals to last name, and we have first name, last name, email, username. Okay. We have password, so I'll take password only one. Because we need only one password, okay. So that's why I'm taking only one password. And after creating this object of user, we have to save this information. So a user, I'm saying user dot save. We're getting this much like message user. We are getting this. So what we have to do? We have to import the library also, right? So what after this render? Redirect library and one more library we have to import from Django dot context. You can find all the libraries from the internet, okay, and the Django documentation, okay, and
authentication, the first we have to import this user, okay, because how it is taking the authentication, okay? So, and one more thing for messages, we have to write django.config. This for this username equals user, how it will do the authentication with the help of this library. Okay. Then we have saved this messages. Okay, so once you save it, okay. So I need one message. Okay, so the message should be like a print. Until the user is created, and type this message. And user created successfully. So I'll pass this message in the message box. Messages dot info. There are many things are there, okay? Not the info. Request. So I'll pass this message user. And then I'll pass one more. Okay, now after this, after printing this message, it should be redirect to where register is. And redirect to the register page. Okay. And we have. Right. So we have passed the message and we have read two conditions. Right? After that, what I have tried this else. I think close this part also. Right? So here I'll write something very render and I have to pass this message here request dot register. Register dot let me copy this dot. Okay. Then if this else and what about statement of okay, what about this else? So for this else what we can pass using creative for this we can pass the same. For this if user is created we are creating, okay? So if something is not working we have to pass message. What we can pass something like password is not matching something type of message, okay? So just change this thing. Pass the message in the info format. Write a request and pass the message in the password. It should be again, it should be directly here the register page because we are starting the register. Okay, and so after completing the thing, you can pass to the home page. Okay, so we have done this part. Now go to the login part. Okay, so in the login, what we have to do, okay, so in the login part, what we have to do, we have to check the same thing. So first create the login page. So this is your login page, and what exactly you want. And here we need a login. On page, thinking we have to pass action, and should we go to the login? The confidential needs to post. Okay, and in this we need only two things, right? Just a new type of username. Okay, type of text in the place folder and the type username. Username and password. There are the two things we require. Password. Okay, you have right. Password. Next, we need a login page. Button value and view. Let's check it's working or not. Login, this button is working, right? And register button is also working. Okay. So let's add the functionality for views, okay, the login part. So same thing what you have typed, we have typed the if request goes to the method and it should be in a which format, number equals to post to, and what you have to do is column. Okay. So it should be like username, it should be the username. Should be equals to the request we have mentioned is again and again the user. And the password also request dot post password. After this you have to do the authentication, right? How you do the authentication? So authentication, so auth, okay. And we have a command called authenticate. And we have the username. And the password will be equals to password. Okay, this is the, and after this, what if the user is not, what you can say, if user is something like not there, it means none. Okay, if user is not none. Okay. Over auth dot login and you have to pass the method of the request. And the redirect to else it should go to the file and bring them, you say something like okay, the user is not fine, and then it should return and direct to the same page, means login for okay, or else the complete path is done, then what? And then go to the return to the return feeder. Make sure the control flow should be same, otherwise we'll get the error. Okay. And what about the logout page? It's just what to check. Authentication dot logout. Again, and we are not adding any information here. Okay, so what we are returning now, just we are adding return. So once it is logged, it should not go to anywhere, just go to the home page. Okay. So we have added our functionality, okay, and make sure that the URL it should be connected. Okay. So just go to the main URL and it should. So accounts is added, right? And in the account URL, everything is added. Login, logout, picture. Yes, everything is added now. So what is next now? The views also done. Okay, and we have done the accounts URL part also. The path view, everything is done. And if we go to the index.html, okay. So once a user is created, what we write actually, we want to display his name also, the user name also, the particular user name. Okay, so how we can display that name? So here we can do the authentication part. For example, if user is authenticated. Then what? So it should display a name something. What name? Hello, something like welcome. Okay. Name. Okay. I just want to display the new one. So you have to mention user dot username. User dot username. Okay. And if the particular after this, what we can display, we can display a logout button. After the logout. Okay, it should close the condition. But else, if the user is not logging, then it should display this register and login button. Okay, and we have to close it. So I'll close this condition. So we have done this part. Okay, so let's do both everything. Go to the file, follow the link. Okay, and it's showing like hello admin because we have logged in with the admin part, right? So just log out
and register with a new user. Okay, I'm writing something name, any name, something like John. Okay, so here I'm writing the enter username. I'll write John. Email, something like john@gmail.com. Okay, enter your password, for example 1234 I'm giving. Let's go 12 and register, and it is displaying the message. Are you finding any message? Because mission super created and the password, we're not getting any message, right? Because we haven't passed the message. Okay, we have to pass the message where we want to display a message. Okay, so for that purpose, in the register.html, we have to pass the message. Okay, because we haven't passed the message. If we just go to the database and column, I'll just refresh it. And for this user, if I create all rows, see, we have till only admin is there. Okay, we don't have any user with the John. Okay, which is not created because we haven't we have given the wrong ID password. But where's the message? We should display some message, right? The password is not matching something. So we have to go to the register.html, and here we have to pass the message. So I pass the message here. So here I can write something. In the for loop, I can write the message, right? Because whatever the message I want to pass, so that from n in message. Should we display something like Mahishu something? Pass right n because we are using a for loop and you have to close the for loop n for save it and do once again. I'll write something again, Sean. Your email ID, john@gmail.com, enter the password, and here I'll write 12, and it is showing that password not matching. Okay, so it's coming three times. We have closed the for you. You can check later, it provides coming three times. Okay, but the thing is like, message is coming, right? Now what we have to do, we have to create a user. Okay, let's write now, we'll add John, and here I'll write John, enter your email, john@gmail.com, enter the password, I'll write 1234, and again 1234, and register. Is string with the message user created successfully. Now go to the folder and click on the all rows. And now you can see we got the user with the name of John. Okay, let's see like we can log in with the name of with the help of with the login page. Okay, so just go to the login page. Okay. So we have to give a login page also, okay, in the register. Okay, so once you are practicing, so give the login page to the register page. Okay, so after registration, they can log in also. Okay, or you can redirect, re-login also. You can give different functionalities. Okay, I'm clicking the login. So here I'm writing the John and for message. Okay, if I are entering wrong password or something, I want to paste this message where in the login page also. Okay, so I'll do the same thing. Okay, and make sure you are passing the
refresh. Okay, I'll write John and password. I'm writing 1 2. User not found. If I write something, any name, something like rock password, something I'm entering, user not found. It looks like the correct password John 1234. So now you can see we are redirecting to the home page and showing the name Hello John. If I in the in view, or not view, in the index, if I mention instead of username, if I mention something like last name, what will happen? Let's see. If I'm mentioning the last name, refresh, so it's saying Hello Tina. Okay, so whatever you right here, it will display the same thing. Okay guys, so that's it all about the Django. And if you want to learn more something, so please comment on that this video. Hope you like this video. If you have any issues, just please comment. So you can email us. Okay, so that's it. Thank you for watching.